Hi guys, welcome back again. So in that last class we have discussed about what actually the moment of inertia is, and I think you understood very well the concept of moment of inertia. And in this class the theorems related to moment of inertia we are going to see. So what actually the perpendicular axis theorem and the parallel axis theorem. So finding out a moment of inertia of an object about any different axis. So by using these two theorems we can easily find out what is the moment of inertia. Initially we have seen that the elementary area moment of inertia about y axis and about x axis. So if you know those values, if you want to find out the moment of inertia about any other axis, let's say if you want to find out the moment of inertia of a body, if you know the moment of inertia of a body about one axis, so if you want to find out the moment of inertia of the same body about another axis, so at the time we are going to use the theorems of moment of inertia, that is what perpendicular axis theorem and the parallel axis theorem. So in this class we are going to discuss about the perpendicular axis theorem. So what actually the theorem states, that is if you know the moment of inertia about two axes, if the three axes are perpendicular to each other. So that means, so for explaining this theorem I want to take one example, that is the small disk. So let's say this is the small disk, let me say that. Ink is over actually. Here the ink bottles are not available here. So that's why I'm existing. So tomorrow I'm going to bring one more ink bottles so that you may see clearly. So exist for this today. So this is what the disk what I have taken. Now draw the axis. Imagine. This is a disk actually, one axis here, one axis is here. So one more axis is perpendicular axis, no? Let me say, I think you have a disk, no? CD, compact disk. So on the disk, one is x axis and one is y axis, one is perpendicular to that, no? So that is z axis. So these two, three axes are perpendicular to each other. So these two axes are in the plane. For let's say this is x axis, this is yy axis, this is zz axis. So these three are perpendicular to each other. So among these two axes are in the plane. So this one axis is passing through the plane. So these two are in the plane, in the third axis, which is perpendicular to these two axes, are passing through that plane. So if you know the moment of inertia of this CD about this x and y axis, let's take, this is an elementary area, I am taking dA. So if I want to find out this moment, elementary area moment of inertia about this xx axis, what I need, the distance between these, let me say this is y. What is ixx? Is area into y square. This is the elementary area moment of inertia. So similarly, so I want to moment of inertia about this elementary area about this yy axis. What I need, this is x distance, so Iyy equal to dA into x square. So if I want to know the total area moment of inertia about this x axis, so I need to integrate this. If I want to know the total area, the total area moment of inertia about this yy axis, I need to integrate this. So this is total area moment of inertia, total area moment of inertia about xx axis, total area moment of inertia about yy axis. So if you know, I am explaining perpendicular axis theorem. So So if you know the perpendicular, the moment of inertia about these two axes are perpendicular to each other in the plane. So by using those two, we can find out the what is the moment of inertia about this whole area, about this axis, which is not in the plane, but it is passing through the plane. This is ZZ axis now. This is perpendicular to these two axes and it is passing through the plane. So I have the values of moment of inertia about this total area, about this XX axis and YY axis. I want to find out the moment of inertia of this total area about this ZZ axis. So at that time I need to use the theorem called perpendicular axis theorem. So what is the formula? IZZ, moment of inertia of this total area about this ZZ axis, equal to IXX plus IYY. So that means if I know the moment of inertia about IXX of this area, if I know moment of inertia about IYY of this area, IYY. So if you sum up this, then I can easily find out the moment of inertia of this total area about this ZZ axis. So there is a, some proof is there, but that proof is not important. Very small proof is there. If anybody wants, please comment me in the comment box. I will explain. But this is not important. So here one more result is there you need to remember. So what is the moment of inertia of this total area about ZZ axis? That is IXX plus IYY. So, but this is the case, but IYY is not equal to IXX plus IZZ. Similarly, IXX is not equal to IYY plus IZZ. These are in planes, na? In the plane, these X and Y axis are there. So I want to find out by using these in-plane moment of inertia of this out-plane moment of inertia which is passing through the in-plane, which is passing through the plane. So this is what the perpendicular axis theorem states there. What actually perpendicular axis theorem states that is, so if three axes are there, those axes are perpendicular to each other. Among those three axes, two axes are in the plane and one more axis which is passing through the plane. So that is also perpendicular to the two different axes. So if you know the moment of inertia of two axes in the plane, you can easily find out the moment of inertia of this third axis which is passing through the plane by using the perpendicular axis theorem. This is what the theorem states that. So by using this theorem, we can easily find out the moment of inertia of any axis. So this is the perpendicular axis here. Now we will see what is the parallel axis here. Okay. Now, I think you understood the perpendicular axis theorem. By using perpendiculars, we are finding perpendicular axis theorem. But this is very important, parallel axis theorem. For that, I am taking one object. This is the object. This is the centroidal axis which is passing through the centroid of that. This is a centroidal axis. I am considering one elementary area. So you know, so in the next class we are going to find out how to find out the moment of inertia of the regular sections about the centroidal axis. So at the time again I am going to explain here, but for the sake of this understanding of theorem, understand that, assume that you know that what is the moment of inertia of this area about the centroidal axis which is passing through the centroid of that object. So if I want to find out the moment of inertia about another axis, one more axis which is not exactly passing through the centroid of that whole object. So that means I know this this is passing through the centroid of this whole object. So I know this moment of inertia as CG, centroidal axis moment of inertia. So I want to find out the moment of inertia of this whole body about this axis. So for that, what I am doing is that I am considering one area, elementary area. This is dA. Okay. Now I want to know what is the moment of inertia of this elementary area about this yy axis. So this one more axis, I am taking that this is zz axis. Actually, what is that? what is my aim is that I know the moment of inertia of this whole body about this centroidal axis. I want to find out what is the moment of inertia of this whole body about this zz axis. I want to find out. So for that, I am using parallel axis theorem. So Izz equal to ICZ centroidal axis plus area into y square. Here y is nothing but the distance between two parallel axes. These are parallel to each other. So that is why this theorem is called as parallel axis theorem. So this is what the formula. I am explaining here. If I know one object, I know the area of the total object, I know the mass of the total object, and also I know the moment of inertia of the total object about the centroidal axis. So I want to find out the moment of inertia of that same object, which I have know the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis. I want to find out the moment of inertia of the same object about one more axis which is parallel to the centroidal axis but not in the centroid. So it is centroid. This is the axis which is passing through the centroid. This is centroidal axis. I know the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis. So I want to find out moment of inertia about this axis. So at that time we need to use the parallel axis theorem. So that is nothing but, so this is ICZ, that is nothing but moment of inertia about the centroidal axis. We know, we will discuss in the next class, but assume that we know, we can easily calculate the moment of inertia about centroidal axis of any object. So that's why I'm saying that we know that centroidal axis moment of inertia. So plus A, the area of this total object into what is the distance between two parallel axes. This is y square. So this is the expression for finding out a centroidal axis, centroid moment of inertia of an object about any axis other than the perpendicular axis. So these are the two. This is also having one theorem, but it is not important as far as this examination concerned. So remember what actually the theorem and how we can use that theorem for finding out a moment of inertia. Perpendicular axis theorem states that if you want to find out a moment of inertia about any axis which is perpendicular to each other, so that is equal to summation of in-plane perpendicular axis moment of inertia. So Izz equal to Ixx plus Iyy. Here, what is the parallel axis theorem? It says that if you want to find out the moment of inertia of any object which is not passing through the centroid at some distance away from the centroidal axis, so if you know that centroidal axis moment of inertia and the distance between the two parallel axes, we can easily find out Izz equal to ICZ plus, that means centroidal axis moment of inertia plus area of the total object what you are interested to find out moment of inertia into the distance between two parallel axes square. So this is what the theorem, parallel axis theorem and perpendicular axis theorem. In the next class we are going to find out, so we assume that moment of inertia of about centroidal axis. So in the next class we are going to find out how we can find out the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis for given sections which was given in the notification, rectangular, triangle, circular sections are. And after that we are going to find out moment of inertia and radius of gyration for composite sections, as similarly we have did in the centroidal. For first we have find out the centroid for regular sections like rectangle, triangle, parabola and circle. After that we have found out centroid for composite sections, I section, L section, C section, T section. Similarly, this is the moment of inertia. First we need to find out moment of inertia of regular sections about the centroidal axis. After that we are going to find out the moment of inertia of composite section. So the same concepts are there. Concept is different, the same procedure. So this is the theorem. parallel axis theorem and perpendicular axis theorem. So thank you.